I'm Shivvy Jervis, and you're tuned in to NextTech Insider, where we banter with some of the most eclectic and inspiring thought leaders to get their take on where some of the most creative applications of existing and future technologies are headed and what they'll do for us, both as businesses as well as everyday consumers. With me today is Mark Stevenson. So you are a big name influencer in data, and so I'm delighted to have you here.
Thank you very much.
So no pressure, I'm going to open with a sort of context setting question. I want to try and understand the kind of evolution of data practice within an organization. In my humble opinion, I've seen it evolve from more business intelligence and standard reporting to something that's now in the realm of sort of advanced AI and more predictive analytics. What are your thoughts on that?
I think certainly in the time I've been involved in data, I've seen the evolution of analysts right through to more data scientists. So ultimately, the reporting and all of the storage of data is still happening now. It's happening at a vaster scale. So we're using far more advanced technologies because we have far more data being created on a daily basis than we'd had for millennia prior. So now we're able to use open source storage, and we're able to use open source programming technologies to be able to really deliver some actionable insight from this vast swathe of data that we have at our disposal now.
And you can't talk about data without talking about some of the advanced algorithms powering it. Tell me what we need to know about that.
Algorithms, they're everywhere. So we live now in an algorithm society. Whether that's good or bad is up to us as a society, in my opinion, to define. So on a daily basis, everyone's lives are being defined by various algorithms. How you get to work, what are you going to have for breakfast, where are you going on holiday? All of these things are being focused in by our algorithmic choices that we're using. Now, the danger is obviously algorithms, by their very definition of bias, if they're program bias, you then create the feedback loop, and before you know it, as a society, we have to be very careful that these feedback loops don't come back to hurt us when we need them most.
Indeed, because algorithms can imbibe, create a bias, and indeed the negative impulses of the person that's actually programmed it.
Absolutely, and I think on an ethical level we have to be careful, because obviously we allow algorithms now to define our financial rating, you know, our property rating. A lot of our rating is defined by scoring, but we need to be careful we don't shift to a social rating. Indeed, in China, they've already implemented some of this, where our interactions, how we interact with others, how we interact with technology, all of that's being scored, and then you're being put into a league table of life. That's scary.
It's almost like a slightly kooky storyline for a movie, but it's actually happening.
It's Black Mirror stuff.
Yeah, very much, very surreal. So I want to understand then in this space, the sort of jobs market and opportunities for talent, either wanting to break in, and for those who are already working within the space that are thinking about needing to upskill and be future-proof as well, perhaps either to take on the role of a data scientist or indeed to handle something that straddles data and AI and cloud and having to really make sense of that for their organizations. What's the landscape looking like for jobs in this space?
The sexiest job of the 21st century was the data scientist. Indeed, last year, I think in the US, the data scientist was the most talked about role. I think moving forward, we are all becoming part of this data science universe. Indeed, citizen data scientist is the phrase that's being thrown around. We all have access to technology, wearables, our phones that are analyzing our movements, our interactions. So we're able to create our own dashboards and make informed decisions about our own behaviors.
How does the data science market then further fragment itself and evolve?
Well, I think within data science, you have so many subdivisions anyway. You have people building advanced recommender systems for your Netflix or whatever you're watching or reading. You then have NLP, you have computer vision. We analyze, you know, everyone's on Insta, everyone's looking at pictures daily. And also deep learning. getting into far more advanced neural network computing. So I think someone looking to specialize in one of those areas, that would be wise. Also, we have to think about the next gen, which is quantum computing. The quantum data scientist will be the next big role.
When we talk about data though, you absolutely cannot avoid discussing consumer privacy. This is top of mind for everyday citizens and consumers. And then of course the organizations and businesses that are handling those vast streams of data are very, very aware of it. And of course there's legislation around this in Europe as well. But how could organizations, governments, actually reconcile this sort of trade-off for the user, let's just say user, whoever that user is, whether it's B2B or B2C, to say, well, here's what you're getting for the data, ergo, this is why you're giving us this data. How might they straddle that?
Well, I think personalization is absolutely defined by data. So as long as companies are transparent and they explain this is what we're going to use and this is why we're going to use it, I think that brings with it a level of trust where they will be able to breed loyalty. Loyalty comes from trust. So I think as long as a company is being open and giving choice, then that shows they're being serious about their privacy. I think personally, there's a generational situation here whereby the millennials are far more comfortable with having their data out there than perhaps those that aren't necessarily as tech savvy or digital savvy. I mean, Deloitte did a survey of about 8,500 people across 6 countries, and 79% came back and said they were comfortable having their data used, provided they could see the benefit to them. So I think everyone's okay with it, provided they can understand why.
Gotcha. And we're in a good place now. So this is a great place to build this momentum from and use data responsibly.
Yes.
And so that it works both ways, both for the organizations that are harnessing it, but also the end user.
Absolutely.
Wonderful. Mark, thank you for being in conversation
with
us.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for watching.